What is going on, guys? Welcome back to WWE Pit. Today we're looking at the WWE's greatest returns from injury. At number six, The Undertaker. The Undertaker seems to have had a couple of dozen returns in his career so far, with probably a couple more left to go. It's a character that you don't want overexposed, so Taker knows when it's time to take a break. Add that into a long history of injuries, and at times it seems that he has gone more often than he's around. Arguably, Undertaker's greatest return, though, was almost his most shocking one. For the first time, we saw the dead man look human. On an episode of SmackDown in 1999, The Undertaker was fired by Vince McMahon. In actuality, he just needed a few months off to heal from an injury. Those few months turned into the better part of a year, when he ended up tearing a pectoral muscle as well. At Judgment Day, the evil finally returned. The Rock and Triple H were engaged in an epic 60-minute Iron Man match, but Rocky had the deck stacked against him. The entire McMahon-Hemsley regime was out to screw over the Great One. What they weren't counting on, though, was the returning Undertaker barreling down the entry on a motorcycle, gone with the goth outfit, but instead he was dressed in a bandana and a long trench coat. Undertaker quickly manhandled the entire group and delivered one of the greatest choke slams of all time on poor X-Pac. While Undertaker inadvertently cost The Rock the match, the night will still be better remembered for his remarkable return that began a new chapter in his legendary career. At number 5, The Big Show. For his 35th birthday, it seemed like The Big Show was ready to hang up the tights or the big sweaty singlets after years in the business. His body was hurting bad. He needed a break. No one was quite sure when or if the big man would return to the ring. Eventually, he came back after more than a year's absence at No Way Out. Unluckily for Rey Mysterio, Show wanted to hurt somebody his first night back, and he went after the much smaller grappler. While Big Show had been getting stale before his time off, he returned to a hot angle that freshened him up and put him right back in the spotlight. At number 4, Triple H. No matter what you may think of Triple H as a person or as a character, you have to admire his toughness. During a tag team match on Raw with Steve Austin against Chris Jericho and Chris Benoit, Hunter tore his quadriceps, putting him out of action for 8 months. Somehow he finished the match and even took a lion tamer from Jericho. It was a bad time for Hunter to go down too, as the invasion angle was only a few weeks away from starting. He ended up missing out on the entire storyline, which had to have been a frustrating experience. Things got better for him though as months went on. The WWF started to run some first-rate videos hyping his return that were accompanied by U2's Beautiful Day. After so much time on the sideline, the game finally returned to Madison Square Garden and a monster pop. At number 3, The Rock. Finally, The Rock came back to the WWE. It was like fate bringing The Rock and the WWE Universe back together on Valentine's Day. It gave the crowd the perfect chance to show how much they loved and missed the Great One. Many thought he'd never appear again, let alone wrestle. He didn't need to. He made a gigantic sum of money becoming one of the biggest movie stars on the planet. It would be hard to blame him for never associating with wrestling again. But he did, and it was electrifying. Rock's music played and he emerged to perhaps the biggest pop the company had received in years. Once in the ring, it was like he hadn't skipped a beat. He cut a passionate promo that was both funny, promoted WrestleMania 27, and managed to tear down John Cena, much to the delight of the crowd. Rock knocked it out of the park that night, and it was good to know that he was back in the family. At number 2, Chris Jericho. Chris Jericho had never been a huge star on the level of Steve Austin or Rock, but he still manages to come up with the most interesting ways to return. What made Jericho's 2007 return so good was how well done the short videos hyping it up were. The videos were cryptic. They contained a series of random text and computer codes that appeared nonsensical. The only words that could be visibly made out were "Save Us 222. But what exactly did that mean? A series of theories popped out online that brought forth compelling evidence attempting to explain it. Most fans searching for clues came to believe it was Chris Jericho. But WWE's most awesome but random clue contained a website hidden in the video that would be accessed, which had the image of a 14th century Icelandic manuscript that detailed the walls of Jericho crumbling. The vast majority of fans were left in the dark about the true meaning of these images, but it was a great way to get hardcore fans even more excited for the impending return of Y2J. And finally at number 1, Jerry the King Lawler.
As Titus O'Neil continues to hammer away. Jerry, talk to me, buddy. Jerry.
Jerry Lawler had the shortest absence from WWE by anyone on this list, but his return was the most emotional. On the September 10th episode of Raw, Lawler suffered a heart attack on the air. It was a strange moment for everyone, as the commentary suddenly went silent. Over the course of the night, a visibly distraught Michael Cole filled us in on what happened. As the show progressed, we weren't even sure if Lawler was going to live. Thankfully, by the time the show ended, we found out that he had pulled through and was going to be okay. For weeks after, WWE updated us to his condition and announced that he would be returning to commentary. And shortly after 2 months following his heart attack, Lawler returned to WWE's flagship show to much fanfare. An emotional Lawler thanked the fans for all their thoughts and prayers. It was a perfect ending to the story, until WWE actually went into story mode and brought out CM Punk to cut a promo on him. While the added angle was unnecessary, it still couldn't take away from how great it was to see the King back on his throne. And that's gonna wrap it up for this episode of WWE Pit. I hope you guys enjoyed. If you did, leave a like, comment, subscribe, and hit that bell so you never miss an upload. And I'll see you guys in the next video. Goodbye.